Dear students, myself Suguna H.G., Assistant Professor, Department of Mathematics, GFGC and PG Center, Chintamani. In this video, I am presenting you Mathematics Paper 7 of BSc, Unit 1, Linear Algebra. We are going to learn about the definition of linear dependence and linear independence, Theorem 1. Let V be a vector space over F, then result 1, a subset of V containing 0 vector is linearly dependent. Result 2, a set consisting of single vector alpha is linearly independent if and only if alpha is not equal to 0. Third result, every non-empty subset of a linearly independent set is linearly independent. Fourth result, every superset of a linearly dependent set is linearly dependent. Then theorem 2. An ordered set alpha 1, comma alpha 2, comma alpha 3, so on alpha n of non-zero vectors is linearly dependent if and only if one of the vector alpha k such that k is lying between 2 to n is a linear combination of its preceding vectors. Theorem 3. A finite set of non-zero vectors has a linearly independent subset which spans the same subspace. So these are the concepts we are going to learn in this session. Now first, definition of a linearly dependent and independent vectors. The vectors alpha 1, comma alpha 2, comma alpha 3, so on alpha n of vector space Vf are said to be linearly dependent if the linear combination c1 alpha 1 plus c2 alpha 2 plus c3 alpha 3 plus so on plus cn alpha n is equal to 0 and at least one scalar is non-zero. See, out of these scalars c1, c2, c3, so on cn, at least one scalar should be non-zero if the vectors alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3, so on alpha n of V of F are said to be linearly dependent. And the linearly independent means if the linear combination C1 alpha 1 plus C2 alpha 2 plus C3 alpha 3 so on plus Cn alpha n is equal to 0 implies that C1 is equal to C2 is equal to C3 is equal to so on Cn is equal to 0. Means all scalars are zeros, then the linear combination of the vectors c1 alpha 1 plus c2 alpha 2 plus so on cn alpha n is equal to 0 implies c1 is equal to c2 is equal to c3 is equal to so on 0. If scalars are equal to 0, then those vectors are linearly independent. See, if linear combination is equal to 0, which implies all scalars are zeros, then the vectors set alpha 1, alpha 2, so on will be linearly independent. Let us prove the theorem 1. So theorem 1, let V be a vector space over F, then the first result, a subset of V containing 0 vector is linearly dependent, and 2, a set consisting of single vector alpha is linearly independent if and only if alpha is not equal to 0. Every non-empty subset of a linearly independent set is linearly independent, and every superset of a linearly dependent set is linearly dependent. So we have to prove these four results when V is a vector space over F. Let us take the first result. A subset of V containing 0 vector is linearly dependent. Let the set S is equal to alpha 1, alpha 2, so on alpha I, so on alpha n. Let alpha I is equal to 0. When alpha I is equal to 0, it is clear that the linear combination 0 into alpha 1 plus 0 into alpha 2, so on 1 into alpha I plus so on 0 into alpha n is equal to 0. And Ci is not equal to 0, therefore it is linearly dependent. Let S is equal to a set containing only one vector alpha. and let it be a linearly independent. If alpha is equal to 0, then by the result 1, S is a linearly dependent and it is a contradiction. Hence, alpha is not equal to 0 because we have to show that S is a linearly independent. So, conversely, let alpha is not equal to 0, then the combination C into alpha is equal to 0, which implies that C is equal to 0 or alpha is equal to 0. Since alpha is not equal to 0, definitely C is equal to 0. Hence, S is linearly independent because the scalars is equal to 0 means the vectors are linearly independent. Third result, let S is equal to alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3, so on, alpha I, so on, alpha n be linearly independent set. And let us consider a subset T of S as T is equal to alpha 1, comma alpha 2, so on, alpha I. Then consider it's a linear combination, that is C1 alpha 1 plus C2 alpha 2, so on, Ci alpha I is equal to 0. Further, this can be extended to next elements, that is C1 alpha 1 plus C2 alpha 2 plus C3 alpha 3 plus so on C1. So, which implies the C1 alpha 1 plus C2 alpha 2 plus so on Ci alpha I plus 0 into alpha I plus 1 plus so on plus 0 into alpha n is equal to 0. This implies that C1 is equal to C2 is equal to C3 is equal to Ci is equal to Ci plus 1 is equal to Cn is equal to 0. Because S is a linearly independent set, all scalars must be equal to 0. Hence, T is a linearly independent set. Fourth one, let S is equal to alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3, so on, alpha I be linearly dependent set. Let T be the superset of S, means S is contained in T. So, let T is equal to alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3, so on, alpha I, so on, alpha n. So, it contains n elements and S is a subset of T. Therefore, T is a superset of S. Since S is a linearly dependent, so the linear combination C1 alpha 1 plus C2 alpha 2 plus C3 alpha 3 plus Ci alpha I is equal to 0 implies that at least one scalar is non-zero because S is linearly dependent. And further, this implies C1 alpha 1 plus C2 alpha 2 so on Ci alpha I plus 0 into alpha I plus 1 so on 0 into alpha n is equal to 0. At least one scalar is non-zero here. Hence, T is also linearly dependent set. Theorem 2. An ordered set alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3, so on, alpha n of non-zero vectors of a vector space Vf is linearly dependent if and only if one of the vector alpha k, where k is lying between 2 to n, is a linear combination of its preceding vectors. Here we have to show that alpha k can be expressed as a linear combination of its preceding vectors. So let S is equal to alpha 1, alpha 2, so on, alpha n be linearly dependent set of non-zero vectors. So S is a set of non-zero vectors. No zero element is present in S. Then there exists scalar C1, C2, Cn, not all zero, such that the linear combination C1 alpha 1 plus C2 alpha 2 plus C3 alpha 3 plus so on Cn alpha n is equal to 0. Let Ck be the last non-zero scalar, then C1 alpha 1 plus C2 alpha 2 so on Ck alpha k is equal to 0. K cannot be equal to 1. If k is equal to 1, then C1 alpha is equal to 0, which implies that C1 is equal to 0 or alpha 1 is equal to 0. If C1 is equal to 0, all scalars are zeros, implying that S is linearly independent. This is a contradiction because we have considered S is a linearly dependent set, so C1 cannot be equal to 0. If alpha is equal to 0, then the S of zero vectors, this is contradiction. Hence, k is always greater than or equal to 2. This implies that ck alpha k is equal to c1 alpha 1 minus c2 alpha 2 minus c3 alpha 3 minus ck minus 1 alpha k minus 1. Now, we equate this to alpha k. C1 by k alpha 1 minus c2 by k alpha 2 minus c3 by k alpha 3 so on minus ck minus 1 by k alpha k minus 1. Now let us take these fractions minus c1 by ck minus c2 by ck minus ck minus 1 by k as d1, d2, dk minus 1 respectively. Then alpha k is equal to d1 alpha 1 plus d2 alpha 2 plus d3 alpha 3 so on plus dk minus 1 alpha k minus 1. Conversely, let alpha k is a linear combination of its preceding vectors. That is, alpha k is equal to d1 alpha 1 plus alpha 2 plus d2 alpha 2 plus d3 alpha 3 so on dk minus 1 alpha k. Means alpha k can be written as a linear combination of its preceding vectors alpha 1, alpha 2, so on, alpha k minus 1. Now, this implies that d1 alpha 1 plus d2 alpha 2, so on, dk minus 1, alpha k minus 1, minus 1 into alpha k is equal to 0. This alpha k I transferred this side. So, further, this can be written as d1 alpha 1 plus d2 alpha 2 plus so on dk minus 1 alpha k minus 1 minus 1 into alpha k plus 0 into alpha k plus 1 so on 0 into alpha n. Since ck is equal to minus 1, it is not equal to 0, hence s is linearly dependent. Theorem 3. A finite set of non-zero vectors has a linearly independent subset which span the same subspace. To prove this one, let us consider S is equal to alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3, so on, alpha n be a finite set of non-zero vectors. Let the linear span of S is equal to the set containing the linear combinations, that is C1 alpha 1 plus C2 alpha 2, so on, Cn alpha n, such that C1 comma C2 comma so on Cn belongs to F. If F is a linearly independent, then S itself is a required subset. So let us take, if S is a linearly dependent, then there exists a vector alpha k which can be expressed as the linear combination of its preceding vectors. That's nothing but alpha k is expressed as c1 alpha 1 plus c2 alpha 2 plus c3 alpha 3 so on plus ck minus 1 alpha k minus 1. The linear span of S is equal to C1 alpha 1 plus C2 alpha 2 so on CK alpha K plus CN alpha N such that C1, C2, C3, CN belongs to F, which implies C1 alpha 1 plus C2 alpha 2 plus C3 alpha 3 so on CK and alpha K. Let us take the linear combination, that is C1 alpha 1 plus C2 alpha 2 so on CK minus alpha k, because alpha k can be expressed as the linear combination of its preceding vector plus so on cn alpha n c1 c2 so on belongs to F. Now that is a linear span. S is equal to linear span of S1, where S1 is alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3 so on alpha n minus 1. If S1 is a linearly independent, then S1 is required subset of S which span the same subspace. Otherwise, continue this process of deleting vector which can be expressed as a linear combination of its preceding vectors till we get the linear independent subset. That means we should continuously delete one element. See, S has up to alpha elements. S1 has alpha n minus 1. Next, S2 will take alpha n minus 2. S3 alpha n minus 3, like that we have to delete one vector in the set S, and we should see whether the linear combination of its preceding vectors it can be expressed until we get the linear independent subset. Thank you.